This video is brought to you by MyWayTeaching.com.
In this particular part, we are going to study about the speed of efflux and Torricelli's law. Okay. Here the word itself is, it's looking different, right? But its meaning is very simple. The word efflux means fluid outflow. And Torricelli is a scientist who discovered that the speed of efflux from an open tank is given by a formula identical to that of a freely falling body. Okay, both are similar. You just consider a tank, as you can see in this figure. Just consider a tank containing a liquid of density rho with a small hole in its side at a height y. Okay, at a height y 1 from the bottom, there is a small hole. You can see here the air above the liquid whose surface is at height y 2 is at pressure p. From the equation of continuity, we can write V1, A1 is equal to V2, A2, isn't it? So, we can write V2 is equal to A1 by A2 into V1. This is from the equation of continuity. Okay. If the cross-sectional area of the tank A2 is much larger than that of a hole, obviously the cross-sectional area of this A2 is much larger than that of this A1, isn't it? Then we may take the fluid to be approximately at rest at this top portion. So we can say V2 is equal to 0. Now applying the Bernoulli's equation at points 1 and 2 and noting that at the hole where P1 is equal to PA, okay, the atmospheric pressure, so we can apply Bernoulli's theorem. We get PA plus 1 by 2 rho V1 square plus rho g y1, isn't it? That is equal to p plus rho g y2. Taking y2 minus y1 is equal to h, we'll get a value for v1 which is equal to square root of 2gh plus 2p minus pa divided by rho. So when p is very much greater than pa, at that time, 2gh may be ignored. The speed of efflux is determined by the container pressure. Such a situation occurs only in case of rocket propulsion. On the other hand, if the tank is open to the atmosphere, we can say P is equal to PA, isn't it? So at that time, this V1 will be equal to square root of 2gh. Okay. This is the speed of a freely falling body. So, this equation is known as Torricelli's law. Okay. This is similar to the equation of a freely falling body. Now let us study what is venturi meter. A venturi meter is a device which is used to measure the flow speed of incompressible fluid. Okay, it is used to measure the flow speed of flow speed of incompressible fluid. Okay, and it consists of a tube with a broad diameter and a small construction at the middle, as you can see in this particular figure. So it is a tube with a broad diameter, we can say, and a small construction at the middle. Okay, a manometer in the form of a U-tube is also attached to it, with one arm at the broad neck point of the tube and the other at the constriction. See, the manometer contains a liquid density, that is rho m. The speed v1 of the liquid flowing through the tube at a broad neck area A. Okay, at a broad neck area A is to be measured from the equation of continuity. The speed at the constriction, it becomes the speed at the constriction. At the middle, there is a constriction. So, that speed at the constriction is given by V2, which is equal to A by A V1. Then by using Bernoulli's principle, we can write P1 plus 1 by 2 rho V1 square is equal to P2 plus 1 by 2 rho V1 square A by A, because this is equal to V2 is equal to A by A V1. So that we can write P1 minus P2 as 1 by 2 rho V1 square A by A square minus 1. Okay. This pressure difference causes the fluid in the U-tube connected at the narrow neck to rise in comparison to the other arm. Okay. The difference in height H measure the pressure difference, so that the speed of the fluid at the wide neck is given by this wide neck here. So that is the speed at that point is given by V1 is equal to square root of two rho m g h by rho a by a whole square minus 1 whole raised to minus 1 by 2. The principle behind this meter has made many applications. Okay, the carburetor of automobile has a venturi channel through which air flows with a large speed. The pressure is then lowered at the narrow neck and the petrol is sucked up in the chamber to provide the correct mixture of air to fuel which is necessary for combustion. Okay, and even in the filter pumps or aspirators, Bunsen burner, atomizers and sprayers, as you can see in this particular figure, which are used for perfumes or to spray insecticides, work on the same principle. Okay, this is one of the example of spray gun. Piston forces air at high speeds, causing a lowering of pressure at the neck of the container, isn't it? We use perfumes, right? We spray it by pressing the upper piston. All these works on, you know, on the same principle. Okay, they use venturi meter principle. Now let us solve a very simple problem. Blood velocity problem. The question is, the flow of blood in a large artery of an atrophied dog is diverted through a venturi meter. The wider part of the meter has a cross-sectional area which is equal to that of the artery. A is equal to 8 mm square. The narrower part has an area that is 4 mm square. The pressure drop in the artery is 24 Pascal. What is the speed of the blood in the artery? So here, the flow of the blood in a large artery of the dog is diverted through a venturi meter. So the wider part, they have given the cross-sectional area of wider and narrower part, and even they have given the pressure drop. Now we should find the velocity of the or the speed of the blood in the artery. Okay. So for this we should take the density of blood, the value of density of blood from the table. Is given by 1.06 into 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube. So the ratio of the areas A by A is given by. So here they have given A as 8 mm square and narrower part area is 4. We'll get the ratio as 2. Okay, and using the equation, that is V1 is equal to square root of two rho m gh by rho into A by A whole square minus 1 whole raised to minus 1 by 2. So here they have given the value of pressure directly as 24 Pascal. So 2 into 24 Pascal. Divided by 1060 kg per meter cube into this A by A is 2, 2 square minus 1, isn't it? So if you simplify this, two by 24,060, 4 minus 1, which is equal to 2 by 24,060 into 3. So if you simplify this, 3 8s are 2 1s are 3. We get the value of this as 0.125 meter per second. Is that fine? This is the speed of the blood in the artery. Okay. Okay.